You're not going to believe what happened today with Rogers Cable. If Dwayne, the vice president of Rogers Cable, is watching this blog, I want you to call me or go to my website, bronsteintv.com, or email me, tvbigshot@rogers.com, because you're not going to believe this story. I'm talking in the car right now because I just had to take my kid to a rugby game. I took him to a new school rugby game. Plays rugby. All of a sudden, he became British. I don't know what the hell's going on. I'll give him a cup of tea at 4 o'clock. And then all his little friends come over. Oh, you're David Bronstein. You're David Bronstein. Because they watch me, my blogs, all this stuff. And then one of his friends comes over and says, "Hi, David Bronstein. I love your rant about Justin Bieber." He's like, about Justin Bieber. He says, "Hi, I'm Aaron Goodman." And he shakes my hand. I thought, "Oh, it's very nice, Aaron. Jared's always talking about you and all that stuff." He's like a little man. She's like a little man. Shakes my hand, introduces himself. Now, here's the crazy thing. My little boy, who's 16, and Aaron Goodman and all his little friends, they come over, they shake my hand, they introduce themselves like little men. And the crazy thing is, I still feel like a kid. I want to be with them in high school. My wife says, "Get the hell out of that high school. They'll think you're a pedophile going to that high school. Go to that high school." But I don't want to go to the high school because of 16-year-old girls. What the hell do I care? I deal with strippers and porn stars all day, even though I have friends that like little 16-year-old girls. But I never left high school. I'm Peter Pan. I never grew up. I love that. Being a kid. And so it's very strange that I have to pay bills, and I'll talk about Rogers in a minute, and mortgages and car. I never wanted to do that. And that's why all my wife's friends look like they're 125 years old and wrinkly skin, and they got no hair. They look like my teachers when I was in school, and I still look like I'm in high school. And all my friends tell me on Facebook, "If you look the same," because I have that cavalier, savoir-faire, fun, lively, fun, outgoing. I love life. I love living. I'm a hedonist. I live for pleasure. That's why the house looks like a shit house, because I don't put any money in the house. Most of my friends, put all their money in the house. They put $60,000 pools and $150,000 pools, and they renovate beautiful homes. I like to have a beautiful home, too. But if I have the choice of taking $20,000, $30,000, $50,000, and buying and fixing up the house and living there, who the hell wants to live there? I want to go out and have fun. So I take the money and I go out and have fun. The house is like a shit house. That's why I thought I'm going to give the kids my house. I live in now. I know I said sell the house, knock down the house, build another house. I'm not selling it. I'm giving it to the kids that I'm renting out. I'm buying my $4-10 million house on Dunvegan. That's where I'm living, or Post Road. I just came back on Post Road. You should see the estates there. That's where I'm living. So let's talk about Rogers Cable, because I'm about to pull my hair out of my head. I used to be with Bell Canada. I live in Toronto. We're from Philadelphia. Dwayne, if you're watching, listen to this. I was with Bell Canada. The service is absolutely horrible. They were charging me my phone bills were $150 a month, $120 a month, $110 a month. I said, how can my phone bills? What am I calling, the moon? Am I calling Mars? Am I calling the galaxy Alpha Centauri, like in Lost in Space? How can my phone bills be? I don't call China. I don't call you. I got nobody in China. When I want China, I go to China. I have to get Chinese food on Sundays. I don't call China for no reason. How can my bills? Well, because long distance is 5 cents a minute, 10 cents a minute, 25 cents a minute. Whatever the hell Bell was charging me was unbelievable amounts of money for long distance. I said, how could this be? Long distance today is a quarter of a penny, a third of a penny, a half a cent penny. How can I be charging 10, 15, 20, 50 cents a minute like in Philadelphia in 1963? You had to put $3 in for the first minute. How could this be? So the rep said, that's the way it is. Take it or leave it. We're not changing it. That's the deal. Forget it. Goodbye. I said, I'm not going to pay these rates, because I was partners in a long-distance company. I was partners in Lucky Call with Tony Lacavera. You know who Tony Lacavera is? Tony Lacavera now is Wynn Mobile. I was partners with him in Lucky Call. And then I was a spokesperson for Yak. So I know how much, another long-distance company, so I know how much long-distance is. God, we're doing over 12,000 a day when I was with Tony at quarter of a cent a minute, half a penny a minute, whatever the hell it is. Sorry. I left Bell, and I saw commercials on TV. Rogers Cable, got Rogers Cable, Rogers Phone Service, because now they used to be a cable company. They went to phones and everything else, monopolizing the whole world. And $30 a month to get your phone service, terrific. I said, oh my God, $30 a month. Here I am, like a schmuck, paying $150 a month, and I can get it for $30 a month. So I call Rogers. I said, get over here now. I want Rogers service right now. Give it to me. So they come over and they put in a modem. What, you think I know what the hell a modem is? I'm a TV guy. I don't know anything about modems. So they put in a modem and they give me this service. Terrific. All of a sudden, service doesn't work. Doesn't work. I don't have any dial tones. Four times since I had Rogers service, which is since October till the present, now it's April, the technician has to come out and tell me and fix it. Why I don't have a dial tone? People can call. They can leave messages. Can't make any calls. So a few weeks ago, last weekend, no dial tone. And people are calling me. I got no dial tone. On Monday, I can't make any calls. I don't even know if people are leaving me messages. How am I supposed to talk to people and do business? Got no dial tone. So I call Rogers. They have to come out. They say, well, all right, go downstairs, unplug the modem, push the button, look outside. What am I, a technician? What is that? I work for... Not only do I hire Rogers, I have to work for them to get a dial tone in my house. Dwayne, are you listening to this? All I want is a dial tone. You want me to pay everyone on a dial tone? Great. I get my first bill, $60. I call Rogers. I said, how could this bill be $60? I seen that on television. $30, get Rogers, get the phone, get the dial, get the receiver, you get everything. $30 a month. I said, how do I get $60 a month? So I speak to a very nice girl named Kristen. She said, oh, Dave, you have this long distance plan for $20. You call all over North America, all over the world, all over Iran, China, India, even the other galaxy, Alpha Centauri. I said, I don't order this $20. What is this $20 a month? I don't want that. Well, it's a flat rate plan. You call as much long distance as you want. I said, well, have I called $20 worth of long distance? She said, no. I said, why do I have the plan? I didn't ask for the plan. So Kristen was very nice. She said, look, I'm going to take off the plan, and I'm going to credit you the amount of money you would have saved, it would have cost you, whatever. I said, Kristen, excellent service. And so much excellent service, I did a blog. If you look on my Bronstein's World or Bronstein TV, whatever the hell channels I have on YouTube, you'll see Rogers and Kristen and the blog I do of the great service Kristen gave me. Wonderful. That was the last time I got good customer service from Rogers, because here's the deal. Every month, my phone bill, $70, $60, $65, $75. I call her. I said, well, how can my bill see me so much money? Didn't Kristen take off this $20, whatever the hell it is, a month that I'm paying? Yes, we took it off, but now we charge it $2 so you can make long-distance calls on top of the long-distance, which is 5 cents a minute. I said, why are you charging me $2 so I can make long-distance? Well, if you don't charge it $2, long-distance will be higher. I said, all I want to pay is $30, like I saw on the teller, $30. So how do I get from double from 30 to 10? I don't understand this, but like a schmuck, because I'm so cavalier, because I'm so free, because I throw money around, I don't pay any attention to anything. I don't know what the hell is going on. I'm paying every month, whatever the hell it is. So my bills are $60 a month, $75 a month, whatever the bullshit is. Last weekend, 2 weekends ago, no dial tone again. I can't make calls, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, can't nothing. So I call Rogers. I said, I want to cancel the service. Why do you want to cancel the service? I said, because I can't make a phone call. I had to call from another line in the house. I can't take it anymore. How many times do I have to call to get a dial tone in my house? At least when I paid Bell $150 a month, I had a dial tone. Maybe they were charging me $50 for a dial tone or $100 for long distance. I don't know. But now with Rogers, I can't even get a dial tone. So I'd rather pay Bell $150, at least I get a dial tone, versus Rogers pay $60 a month, get no dial tone, but I'm saving $40. Can't use the phone, but I'm saving $40 for a Bell. So maybe there's a good deal with Rogers. So I say, I want to cancel. Oh, you don't want to cancel. What can I do to make you happy? I said, give me a dial tone. Well, I'm going to give you more than a dial tone. I'm speaking to a guy named Sean. Very nice guy. Everyone's very nice. They don't do anything at Rogers, but they're very, very nice. Look, I'm going to give you credit, Mr. Bronson. I'm going to credit you for 2 months and call a technician out. I see how many times a technician, this is uncalled for. This is unheard of. Whoever thought of anything like this could never happen before. You should have a dial tone. You're paying for this service. I said, why am I paying $60 a month? That's all I want to know when I saw a commercial for $30 a month. He said, Sean, don't you go away. I'm going to give you a credit right now for 2 months. That's it. He puts me on hold. Nice music. They don't let you choose the music. They play whatever music they want. Music. And all of a sudden, the phone rings inside. Not my phone, because I don't dial tone. The phone rings, and then somebody else comes on. Hello, how can I help you? I said, I'm just talking to Sean. He says, Sean who? I said, excuse me, I got so much gas, I could drive to Pittsburgh. I said, Sean, who's giving me the credit for two? I don't know who Sean is. What do you want to do? I said, I want to cancel the service. Why do you want to cancel? I said, why do I have to go through this again? I said, Sean's giving me credit for 2 months. He's waiting for a technician to come out. Do you want me to bring a technician out? I said, yeah, you bring the technician out. Great. He'll be out between 8 and 2, 5 and 8, 3 and 6, 2 and 1. Why do I have to be so inconvenienced? Not only do I have a dial tone, now I have to sit waiting for the technician to come out. I can't do anything because not only am I paying $60 a month and getting no dial tone, now I got to sit and wait for the technician to come out. And then I'm on the phone listening to music waiting for Sean to come back. Do you see this amount of time that I can never get back? Not I can ever get back. How can I work to make the $60 to pay him? I can't work though, because I'm sitting waiting for the technician to come out. So it's coming out between 11 and 2, 12 and 8, 6 and 4. He comes out the next day. And he says, your problem is the modem. I said, throw the modem the hell out the window. I don't want any more, but I don't know what the hell. I didn't ask. I called Rogers. I said, I'd like to have your telephone service. It's $30 a month. They said, terrific. I did not say, listen, by the way, do you have a modem? If you have a modem, please bring it over. I'd love to have a modem. I didn't say that. I don't know what the hell a modem is. I don't know the first thing about a modem. I don't know nothing. I'm a TV guy. That's all I know. I'm going to send this blocked all over the networks when they hear this crazy story. The technician comes out and says, I'm getting rid of the modem. I'm going to give you cable. I said, great. Now, in a world where everything is whatever the hell it is, that they're beaming satellites, I got cable. I'm back to 1985 with cable. So the technician takes the modem out of the house, gives me cable. He's with that staple gun. He's stapling all over, stapling the walls, the ceiling, the floor, staple, staple, staple. I had a cob with a spider web like that movie, The Mist, when they went into the drugstore and there was a web of crap all over the place. That's my house. Cables, cables, cables. Nobody else has cables anymore except me. I got cables. 'Cause